Hi all. Right, looks like it's time to start uploading stuff to TYT Nation directly. So here is my video response from about a week ago to TYT Nation on the subject of TYT science.
Hi, my name is Mike, and this is my video response to the Young Turks. Now I'm going to try and do this in just one sitting with no need for editing and so forth, so here we go. I'm a scientist, so this is exactly what I present on. And the reason I feel that this is needed or this is useful is that not only is it interesting, but there's tons of stuff always coming through. Just last year, 2011, the official records in the National Library of Medicine of the States for the number of academic papers in the medical and life sciences was 900,000. And this year it looks like it's going to easily surpass 1 million. So there's just a wealth of information coming through, a lot of it's small and irrelevant bits and pieces, but there's so much that is socially relevant, politically relevant, economically relevant, and relevant not only to your general understandings, but to your life. So let me give you some examples. Do you take food supplements? Maybe you take extra little pills to give you those vitamins, to give you those antioxidants, fish oils, omega-3 oils. There are a lot of tall tales in food supplements, but let's just focus on antioxidants to keep this brief. The standard story goes like this. Antioxidants mop up those nasty free radicals that aim to go and damage your DNA, thereby promoting cancer and aging. This is wrong. And it's well known to be wrong. After the initial excitement in the 80s, there were some massive studies done on huge scales to actually look at whether you could cut down cancer rates with food supplement antioxidants. The findings? Not only nothing, but antioxidants even promoted cancer in some cases. But you're not going to hear about this from the $50 billion per annum food supplements industry. Nor are you likely to hear about it from nutritionists and their numerous websites that also sell antioxidants. In fact, nutritionist is not even a protected term. So I'm a nutritionist, and you can read a couple of books and call yourself a nutritionist too. But the science is there showing that there are dangers and problems with a lot of these. If you don't believe me, it's even on Wikipedia. Just go there. Wikipedia, antioxidants, look it up. So, be informed that there's tons of interesting stuff that is known to science that is not getting through properly. There are lots of relevant political issues as well. Let's take a very standard one, genetically modified foods. Now, do you know that 90% of Americans actually want mandatory labeling on their foods to show whether it's genetically modified or not, just because they want to know what they're eating. But this hasn't been done. And there's a good reason why it hasn't been done, and that's because Monsanto, the company which pretty much dominates genetically modified food worldwide, it's almost a monopoly, and the FDA are close buddies. They always swap people at their top positions. President Obama doesn't help this. Just back in 2009, he appointed the VP of Monsanto, a guy by the name of Michael Taylor, as the senior advisor to the FDA. So this guy is hardly going to put through new laws which are detrimental to the company from which he came and to which he might well return. But then there's also the scientific question of, well, are GM foods more dangerous than other foods? Are organic foods better? And for this, you probably need someone who knows science, who knows the data, to actually go into the papers and tell you what they can see there. So we'll leave that one alone for the moment and move on quickly, just to say that as well as these ongoing stories, which flare up often, there's also new stuff constantly coming through, lots of quirky stories. A great one recently was about LSD as a treatment for alcoholism. It was some old data reanalyzed. And there's always stuff going on about genes and mental health, which is an area which I was heavily in before. And to finish on that note, Why I think you find this of interest is obviously, like I said before, just the vast number of stories coming through which need a professional angle on it. And why I would be such a good person for that is because I am totally qualified and I have my background in a vast array of life sciences. It's really quite unusual. I did my undergraduate in chemistry, biology, specializing in psychology. I then moved on to do a PhD in behavior genetics, which is the whole nature-nurture thing about psychology and mental disorders. Then did child development, animal behavior, some neuroscience, literature informatics, and now I work largely in public health and hospitals. So I've got all of that background, and if you would like to be updated constantly on what's the most interesting and relevant things coming through in science, particularly health and life sciences, and you'd like me to be the one informing you on that, then you know what to do. Like on the like button and comment in the comments. Thank you.